Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the spaces. Today in this lecture we will see how you can perform the two sample TE test. You can see, you can analyze, compare, mean you have to analyze independent sample two test in the spaces. Myself Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me, either of my email IDs are there if you feel any doubt, else simply follow this link for finding the more updated videos. So the two sample independent TE test, first of all, is a parametric test, and this test is used to compare the mean of the two different groups to determine whether it is a whether their population means are statistically different or not. Like here, if I say this is my first population and this is my sample, this is my second population, this is my sample. So if I want to analyze that whether there is any significant difference between their population mean, like mu1 minus mu2 is 0 or not, that is, this is my H0. And also remember that this two sample t-test is also called as the unpaired t-test. It is also called as the independent test, independent two sample t-test, student t-test, or that two sample t-test. All are called as the two sample independent t-test. Whenever we are trying to solve this independent sample t-test in the spaces, there are the two variables. One is called as the dependent variables, or somebody called as the test variable. Second one is called as the independent variable, which is called as the grouping variable. You can see, once we will see in the couple of examples, this window will appears in the spaces, and the here is the called as the test variable. So this test variable is called as the dependent variable. Grouping variable is called as the independent variable. So now, in order to apply this independent sample t-test in the spaces, we must know that two sample independent t-test is commonly used to find to check whether there is any statistical difference between their means of the two groups, whether there is any statistical difference between the two interventions, or you have to say their change scores. But before applying this, using the SPSS, you must satisfy the following requirement, that then only you can apply this independent sample two test in the SPSS. What are those? The number one is, whatever the dependent variable is, that must be the continuous. What is the meaning of the continuous? Like say, if you have the weights of the students in the kg, heights in the inches, scale from the 0 to 100, scale from minus 100 to 500, and so on. That is a value which are in the ranges are there. That's the meaning of the continuous, that is interval or the ratio level. On the other hand, if the variable that is called as the independent or called as the grouping, so that is a categorical. Categorical means that is like say either the male or female, it is implied or unimplied, success or the failure, and so on. That is two or more groups, so that is implied or unimplied, so on. Another thing is that whatever the observation you have taken, these are independent, and the sample you have taken is randomly taken from the populations. And the last two major assumptions are there, whatever the population you have taken, that must be the normally distributed, that's approximately. How you can check that it's a normally distributed, we have already discussed in the one sample t-test. So we will see also in this example, in this video, like we will draw the histogram and then we will check that whether it follows the approximately normal distribution or not. And the last one is the homogeneity of the variance must be there. That is, if you have the two samples, two populations, sigma 1 and sigma 2, that is must be the same are there. So make sure that whenever you want to apply this, this is assumption number 1, this is 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So you have to verify this assumption 5th and 6th only in the SPSS. You can see, you can check the assumption 5 and 6 in the SPSS. But before applying, checking this, you have to make sure that all of your assumptions 1, 2, 3 and 4 met the requirements. Because this assumption we do not need to need the SPSS to compare them. Like you have to check whether it's a continuous, whether it's a categories are there independent, and so on. Now, as we have seen, we know that in our theory class as well as in this lecture, we see the assumption behind the two sample t test is the major one is here, that is a common variance will be there. So it means our target in the SPSS is, firstly we will check whether whatever the information you have given to you, whatever the variables you have taken, whether that condition will satisfy or not. How you can check this condition in the SPSS? So that's very simple, is that for that this is the Levin's test for the equality of the variance will be used. So whenever we are trying to perform this independent sample t-test, it will automatically includes the homogeneity of the variance. For example, if you see this is the output window of the SPSS, and you can see the first column is a Levis test of the equality of variance. So what is the meaning of that? This will tell you whether this sigma 1 k, that is the variance of the first sample, variance of the second sample are same or not. You can also see equal variance assumed or unequal variance assumed. So what is the meaning of that? Whenever you are taking about that, equal variance assumed means that is the difference will be zero, the population variance are equal, and H1 is the population variance are unequal. So it means this is corresponding to my H0, this is corresponding to my H1 for the F test is called as the Levis test for variance. Now once you will perform this one, so how you can perform that? For example, in this we will check that if this SIG value is greater than of the level of significance, if this value is greater than of the level of the significance, then we can say H0 is accepted, that is equal variance assumption is true. So in this case you can see that this number is my, say, level of significance is, say, for example, 5%. So now this number is greater than of the 5%, so the equal variance assumption is satisfied. If it is not, then we will think about this, and then we will look about all those values which are written in this column. And again, when equal variance not assumed means that is a H, this is condition is not satisfied. So we have seen that when the equal variance assumed condition satisfied, then we can calculate the t value by using here. Like you can see this value, this is the case for the equal variance assumed. So how this value be calculated? This value is calculated with the help of this formula, x bar minus y. What is the x bar? First sample mean, second sample mean, mu1 and mu2 is the population means, n1 and n2 are the sample sizes of the first sample and second sample. Capital S is called as the pooled variance. Also you can see this is the degree of freedom. You can see that this is the df is called as the degree of freedom. On the other hand, when this your equal variance is not assumed, then you can see that this value of t is different. Degree of freedom is also be in the decimal, 5.6. So in that case we will compute the t value like here, and the degree of freedom is calculated by this. So make sure that whenever this equal variance assumed, then we compute like here, otherwise we will compute the degree of freedom by using this. Now how we can perform this one is there, we will see. I can discuss these two examples in this video, and some of them is after that. So if you look at the first sample, there are two samples. So, and you can see that then N1 is the number of elements in the first sample, this is my 8. N2 is the number of elements in the second sample, that's a 7. Since N1 is not equal to N2, so what is the meaning of that? It will not be the paired t-test. So remember, whenever N1 is N2, then it may or may not be the paired. But if whenever N1 is not equal to N2, it can never be the paired sample t-test. It is always be the independent t-test. So now what is that? You have to check whether there is any significant difference between them or not. So you can see your H0 will be like here, and H1 will be my mu1 minus mu2 is non-zero. So since it is a non-zero, so we call it as the 2-tailed. So how you can perform that? So it's a very simple. You can simply open your SPSS software, and you can input the sample 1 and the sample 2 elements in the column wise, like here. You can input them. Now once you will input all this information, but if you look at the here, we need the test variables, that is the dependent variables, and these are the independent variables. But if you look about all the values are my here. So what you can do is, you can go to the variable view, define the two columns. One is the X, second is the label. What is the meaning of that? X is called as the dependent variable. So what I can do is, in this dependent variable, I can copy all these values. I can paste here. I can copy all these values, paste here. That is, I can combine all these values in a single file, like here. I can define the values X. I can use the X label here. So I can go to this. I can write the first sample values here. And then I can write the second sample values in the here. What is the label is? Now you can see this value 9 is come from the sample 1. So I can assign the number as a 1. this 11 is again taken from the sample 1, so it is assigned 1. So whatever the value is taken from which sample, you can assign the number accordingly. So you can see this 10, 12, 10 are from here. These are the sample 2. So I can assign the sample 1, 2, 2 and so on. Now once you are assigning this numbering 1, 2 and so on, then you can go to the analyze, analyze, compare mean and independent sample t-test. Once you will click on this, you can see here, you always click on the reset. Now you can see there are the four sample S1, S2 and so on. Okay, before that you have to check whether it's a normality condition satisfied or not. You can go to the graph, you can go to the legency histogram. So I can make them to the variable here. You can press the OK. You can see if the output window will appears. Here you can see this is there. So you can also, I can show you if I draw the histogram again. Here I can draw the normal graph also. I can click on OK. So you can see here, you can see it is approximately with the normal distribution. So you can see the mean is my 11.75, like here. It is approximately normal distribution. Similarly, you can do for this, for the sample 2. So I can do again for here. Now I can remove this value. For the sample 2, I can draw the normal plot. And you can see again here, it is an approximately normally distributed. So it, what is the meaning is that your assumption, that is whether the sample population is follow the normal distribution or not. Now you can go to the analyze, compare mean, independent sample, t-test. So whatever the variable, that is the test value, is called as the dependent values. All those values which are written here with the name X, so I can replace X to be the test value. Grouping factor is the label, and make sure that it must be the scale. So it is, since it is not a scale, so what we that we can firstly change them to be the scale. So X category, I can go here. I can simply replace them to be the scale. And you can change them to be the ordinal or the nominal. That's no problem here. So I can go to here, independent. So you can, I can now X for here. Grouping is my variable. So you can see I can label. So I can put label as a grouping one. Now once you will click here, you can see there are the two question mark appears. So once you click on the define group, so the group one, you have to use the label as a one. So click on the one here. Group 2, that is a group 2, I have used the label as a 2, so you can put as a 2 and then press continue. After that you click on the options, set the level of this confidence level, it's a 95%. So I can press, if you want to set as a 99, you can change them to be the 99, but I can set here as a 95, press continue and then press OK. So once you will press the OK, you can see these two tables will appear. Now I can show you these two tables in my screen here. Now the first table, there is a label here. So there is a first sample consists of the 8 elements. Second sample is consist of, so we can as first sample consists of the 8, second is there. So what is that? This is basically the descriptive statistics of the sample. That is the sample. This is the, what is that? This is nothing but my X bar. This number is my X bar. This is my Y bar is there. Now the first thing you have to do is you have to check the assumption, that is whether the population variance of these two the population variances are same or not. For that you have to check this levels here. Now you can see that what is the SIG is by 0.649. is it greater than of the alpha? Alpha is my level of significance. Yes. So what is the meaning of that? This is this assumption, that is equality is true. That is H0, that is H0 in this case is sigma 1 square minus sigma 2 square is a 0, is my accepted. So what is the meaning of that? It means equal variance assumed condition is accepted. So once it is accepted, then only you can look about this here row. If this condition is violated, then you have to look about this second row. So in this case, this value is accepted. So equal variance assumed is assumption is satisfied. Now we can compute them here. Like, what is the degree of freedom? The first sample consists of the 8 elements, so the degree of freedom of this is 7. Second sample consists of the 7 elements, so the degree of freedom is 6. So the total degree of freedom is my 13. Or otherwise, you can, all of you know that degree of freedom of this is like here. So this is again be a 13. How you find this value of this is? So all of you know that we have already discussed that x bar minus of this s 1 upon n1 plus 1 by n2. So if you substitute value here, we will get this expression. Now, how you make the final decision? Now this is for the t-test. So what is the what is that for the t-test is there? You can see our, this is my equation is that h0 will be equality and this is a node 2 tail. So what we can do is we will see here. So this is my decision. Now, since look at for the t-test and look at again for the SIG value, whether this is a two tail and your assumption is match, yes. So now since both are the same, so its value is my 0.05. But if in certain cases, look at the, if we consider one more example in the later on, if it is a one tail and here is a two tail is given. So it means you have to firstly convert the one tail into the two tail. How you convert into the one tail to the two tail? If the one tail value has a 0.05%, then this value has a multiply by the 2, that is a 0.10. So if this example is a two tail, then it's a fine, it's directly used as here. But if this problem has a one tail, then we have to convert in multiply by 2, then this number will be my 0.10. That we will see in the next example. Now you can compare this number, that is a 0.245. Since this is 0, this is 0.05, this is 1. So where this value lies that? This value lies here. Okay, so that's a accepted reason. Or otherwise, you can also again say, as we discuss here, if this value is, if SIG is greater than of the level of significance, then we can say your, we will fail to rejected H0, that is we may accepted H0, that is there is no significant difference between their two samples mean. Similarly, if you look about the second example are here, you can see the height of the sailors are given to you, height of the soldiers are given to you. So there are the two are there. Again, you can see these are the six numbers. N1 is my 6 and here is my, how many numbers are there? This is my 10. So since both are not same, so it is definitely be a independent sample t-test. Now you have to show that the soldiers are, average height of the soldier is taller than, so I call it the sailor as a 1, soldier as a 2. So what is the meaning of that? This is mu 2 minus mu 1 must be greater than 0 is my H1. And what is my H0 is my, this is here, this. Now since it is a strictly greater than 0, so it means this is a 1 tail. So how you can solve that? That's again very simple. You can open your SPSS software. You can write all these values and then you can write these values are there. So like here, I can show you in this here. So you can see I can write here 63, 65. You can see 63, 65, 68, 69, 71, 72 for the first sample. I write corresponding as a 1. Similarly, we can write for the second argument. And then we can again go to the analyze, compare mean, independent sample, t-test. Press the reset. Now I can put x as a here, label as a grouping. We can define the group as a 1 and 2. Make sure that if you write here as a 3, then you have to write 3 and 4 here. So I can press continue. I can set the level of significance as a 95, confidence interval 95, and press OK. So you can see the output of the file is my 68. I can show you on the big screen here. You can see the first sample consists of a 6 number of elements and so on. Again, we have to firstly check our assumptions. You can see this significance is my 0.453. So is it greater than of the level of significance alpha? Yes. So it means this equal variance assume is my true. So it means we have to look about this row. Again, now this is my two tail for the t-test. Now what in this case, what is my H0 here? Now it is a one tail. So if it is a one tail, now SIG is given to the two tail. So we have to convert this number to be the two tail. So the level of significance for the one tail is my 5%. So for the two tail, level of significance will be my 10%. So now this number will be my 0.10. Now you can compare this 0.922 with this number. So where it lies that? It lies something here. Also, this number is greater than of the level of significance. Now this time level of significance will be my 10%, not with the 5%, because we compare with that two tail only with that two tail. So we can see this number is greater than of here. So again, we may accepted the H0. That is, there is no significant difference between the heights of the sailor as well as the soldier. Also, you can see what is the if you look about this table, what is the mean difference are here? You can see, you can take the difference between them. You can see it's a 0.2. Sometimes it is written as a negative, sometimes it's written as a positive, that depending on the sign of this. If this is a positive, then it is always be the positive. If this is a negative, then this is a negative value. And these are the confidence intervals are there in which your difference values will lies there. So this is the procedure you can apply the testing of the hypothesis for the two sample independent sets. So we will see in the next class how we can say species for the paired sample t-test. So remember that whenever they have the two different samples have the same number of elements, then we may consider that it's a paired sample. So we will see now here is a paired sample in our next class. Till then, you can simply follow this link for finding the more updated videos. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.